God is so good. So good, so good. You have been so good to me. You supply all of my needs. You keep me in perfect peace. Woo! So good, so good. You bless me with these gifts. I'm not trying to lose it. I know I've been so still and sitting in it. Boy, you know I'm going through it. You say there's no excuse, just do it. All I know is I need you right now. Peace, love, light, wisdom, guidance, blessings, and discernment, beautiful souls in this world. I don't know, we are not of this world. Cool to be every day. I don't know the tinga already. I know it's been a while since I've been consistently posting. Just like I let you guys know in the last video, there has been a major period of transitioning happening in my lives, and God told me that it has been transpiring in many of your lives as well. So that explains the reason why you haven't really been seeing me in a consistent manner, right? But God is so good. And let me tell you, in this transition, which I am still currently going through, right? And it's different areas in my life, amen? It's not just one area in my life that a lot of transitioning is happening. It's different areas, it's multiple areas all at one time. And let me tell you, if you don't know how to channel the Holy Spirit, if you don't know how to listen to the voice of God, being in a transition like this is not for the weak. I would tell you that it is not for the weak at all. But let me tell you something. When you do have communion with the Holy Spirit, when you do have intimacy with the Holy Spirit, when you do find yourself at the feet of God in the Spirit, and it could be in every aspect of your life, every area in your life, all hell could be breaking loose. You can be transitioning. You can be, there could be change happening. Change that you weren't mentally, emotionally, spiritually, physically ready for. You understand? And you will be at peace. Like, that's the best way I could put it. You will be at peace. On the opposite end of that, if you did not have communion with the Holy Spirit, if you did not have God, you know, intimacy with God and that relationship with Him, you will be depressed. You will be traumatized. You will be down and out. Beloved, I'm telling you, just knowing God, loving God, seeking His will, and moving in accordance to all of that, literally puts you in a place of peace in the wilderness. It puts you in a place of gratitude in the moments where you don't even know where your next meal coming from, in the moments where you don't even know where you're gonna rest your head, in the moments where you don't even know how you're going to do this and how you're going to be that and where you're going to go. And in those moments you will have peace. Oh my goodness, God is so good. God is so good. And I just come here to tell you to keep finding yourself at His feet. Keep finding yourself at His feet, my God. I feel led to tell you right now, if you never thought about this, or if you've done this before, I challenge you to create a prayer closet, a prayer corner, a sanctuary spot in your home. I don't care if you live in a box. I don't care if you live in a one bedroom, small 500 square feet apartment. I don't care if you live in a 10,000 square foot home. Listen, create you a space in that home where you and God can meet, where you will encounter His Spirit like never before, where that will be you guys' meeting destination for His Spirit to come and transform, for His works, His miracles, and His wonders to come into fruition and manifestation right there in that space, right there in that corner, right there in that closet. Create a prayer corner, a prayer closet, a prayer space where it's just you and God. God has been so good to me, oh my gosh. So good, so good. You have been so good to me. You supply all of my needs. You keep me in perfect peace. Woo! So good, so good. My God. Woo! Hallelujah. God has literally been so good, y'all. So good when I haven't even been good to myself, when I couldn't even do what I needed to do for me, when I couldn't even be who I needed to be, when I didn't see myself as worthy, when I didn't see myself as fit for the position, when I downed and talked myself down and discouraged my own self, God stepped in on my behalf. God stepped in and said, you, Cooley, get out of Cooley's way. My God, my God. So I would forever find myself at His feet. So I'm challenging you today. Find yourself at His feet. I don't care what you're going through. I don't care what you did yesterday. I don't care what you did last night. I don't care what you did 2 years ago. Find yourself at His feet. And all of that will go into the sea of forgetfulness, according to the scripture. Beloved, I love you guys so much. But let me tell you something. God loves you way more. And I love you. I love you. But God loves you way more than I can ever imagine of loving you. God loves you way more. And He wants to meet you. He wants to have a designated time and destination where He can meet you, where He can speak to your heart and your spirit, where He can transform your mind so you can be renewed when you go out and when you come in, when you come in contact with people, in Jesus' name, my God. So I challenge you right now, beloved, create that. Create that space. Create that corner. Create that closet. Okay? I love you guys so much. Big up and bless up yourself. Okay? God is so good.
So good. So good. You have been so good to me. You supply all of my needs. You keep me in perfect peace. Woo! So good, so good.
Hallelujah! God is good all the time and all the time. My God is so good. I love you. Bless up. Stay tuned for everything. If you want to partner with us here at CP17 Visions, please go to the website www.cp17visions.com. Okay, there are so many ways you can partner with us. No, not just financially. If God leads you to sowing financially, that's amazing. If He doesn't, that's also amazing. There's more ways that I'm more interested in to partner with you, to network with you, to fellowship with you, so we can come into unity in this one body of Christ. Amen. So I love you so much. Big up and bless up yourself. Go create that space right now, beloved. Go create that space and offer, just invite God into that space. Invite His Spirit to remain there. Invite His Spirit to have residency right there in that space. And you will be, God will blow your mind of what's to come when you enter into that space, when you leave that space. What that space alone in your home will do for your home and overall as a whole. My God. Not just your material home, but this home, your temple. Amen. My God. Woo! go make that space right now. I love you so much. Big up and bless up yourself. So good, Lord, you've been so good to God.